All right, everyone, we're gonna check out this battery we've been waiting a while for. It's a miniature size 100 amp hour battery. It's by GRENERPOWER, green energy and power life out of Shenzhen. GRENERPOWER technology, obviously made in China. But this battery is supposed to be about roughly half the size of the lithium standard 100 amp hour batteries, but still produce the same amount of power. Do a little unboxing here. Just comes in a standard box. We got some packaging we'll look through, some terminals, and the battery itself. It's got foam packed around here, so we'll get it out of the box and check it out. All right, everybody, there's the battery. It's pretty small. It comes with the M8 terminal lugs on there. Actually, you get two sets, apparently, which is not bad. So you get a spare set. It has integrated handles. That's really nice. Nice baby blue case. And it weighs about 26 pounds. So not too bad. We'll see what the cards say. So share with us. Those are all the different types of batteries they have. So up to 300 amp hour packs. It's pretty decent. A 5-year extended warranty and 10 years of professional technical support. It's kind of standard on all these batteries, is what they say. So we'll really have to see in the specs when we're running this battery. This is the service card that you get. So it shows you to put your order and start date up there. RV, camping, solar, series parallel. And then it shows you you should be wearing insulating gloves and all that stuff. Those are all the certifications, I guess it has. Here's the specs that it claims. So 8.5 inches tall by 9 inches wide by 4.5 deep. 26.5 pounds. 12.8 nominal voltage is 100 amp hour capacity. It says 300 minutes at 20 amps, so we'll be testing around that figure to see, because if you go any more or any less, it's going to throw off the figure. So see if we get the 1280 watt hours. Charge current recommended is 20 amps. Maximum is 100 amps, 14.6 at standard for lithium. Has a BMS with a cutoff. You can do 4 parallel, 4 series. Discharge is 100 amps. That's pretty good. It's not bad at all. Peak is 200 for 3 seconds. You got the BMS cutoff there. It's 300 amps at 31 milliseconds. 10 volts, it's flat out, and it has short circuit protection. It's M8 terminal, so it says nothing about low cutoff. Actually, no, let me take that back. Let's see. Those are the specs down there. 4,000 cycles at 100 DOD. 100 amp BMS. 4P4S. So it can do 52 or 51.2 volts at 400 amp hours. That's not too bad. So 20.48 kilowatt hours. It says extreme heat tolerance and lightweight. So 1/3 of the lead acid equivalent. But yeah, the main thing is the size. That's what we're interested in. This thing is supposed to save space, and being a 100 amp discharge, it's got a pretty good BMS, supposedly. So we have a lithium battery standard size. We're going to get up here and show you the difference. All right, hopefully there you can get an idea of the size. Height-wise, it's the same size as of a standard 100 amp hour battery. But as you can see, this is about the halfway point, so it's a little bit longer than halfway, but it also has a skinnier profile. So this thing is actually smaller, about half the size, because you got this area here, and then it's also cut off long way. So definitely a small battery, easy to grab with the handle. So we're gonna get this thing set up on the charger and the voltmeter. and see what we get. Alright, it shipped at 13.2 volts. So we have a 30 amp charger hooked to it. We're going to charge it and it should cut off at around 14. What did it say on there? 14.6 is where we should be cut off at. So we'll come back and check after this charges up. All right, everybody, we have the GRENERPOWER 100 amp hour mini battery set up with our 1500 watt modified sinewave inverter here. We have a kilowatt meter to monitor the power coming out. We expect about 80 to 85% efficiency out of it. It's an Old Harbor Freight one. So out of 1280 watt hours, we expect to see around 1000 watt hours out of this. That would be good, and it'd be a good indicator that this is a good battery. So the load we're gonna run this halogen light here. If you know anything about these work lights, they get really hot. They draw around 500 watts. So at 1500 watts, this is a third of the inverter's power. So it'll be sitting nice to draw power down. All right, we got the battery hooked up to our power inverter and everything's ready to run. We're just gonna go ahead and flip the power on and then we're gonna go into time-lapse mode right after that. As you can see, the power turned on, 116.8 volts. We're pulling down 4 amps, roughly AC, at 464 watts or so, 61.2 hertz, power factor of 0.98, so modified sine wave there, and that's our kilowatt hours and our time running. So now we're going to just go into the time-lapse mode. All right, we passed 1 kW worth of power. If you notice on the time lapse, we added in that meter in the background there, 12.6, 12.5 volts DC. Still holding pretty good at 1 kilowatt of power. So the magic number we're looking for on the kilowatt meter here is 1.28. 1.28. And we're supposed to have a battery BMS cutoff at 10 volts. Not sure when this inverter cuts off. Maybe 10.5, 10.8. So we'll see how much power we can actually get out of this thing. But it's doing very well right now. As far as I'm concerned, this thing is gonna put out the power it's rated because this is a modified sine wave inverter. So it's far surpassed everything so far. All right, the alarm has sounded at 1.18 kilowatts, which is just about 0.10 under what the battery is rated at. Coming through a modified modified sine wave inverter that is absolutely acceptable. That's just the low battery alarm going off right now. We're gonna run it till it's flat. All right, and it flat out died. All right, so the battery was still pumping out energy, but the inverter cut off at about 10.5 volts. The BMS for this battery says 10 volts. So the battery still had energy to put out. The inverter cut off at 10.5. But the magic number we were looking for was 1.280, as you've seen there. And we got right around 1,200 watt hours out of this battery. On a decent load, we're pulling around 500 watts or so. So excellent, excellent battery. Only time will tell now how long it will last, but it was holding 12.8 volts for a long time. Almost an entire kilowatt of power. All right, that concluded our test. So the number we were looking for was 1.28 kW on the kilowatt meter. We got around 1.20, So perfectly fine for using a modified sine wave inverter, pulling right around 500 watts. This battery did excellent. What this is going to be good for is people who have space constraints. And if you don't mind not having any low temp cutoff, because it didn't say anything about that in the instructions. So if you can have this in an area that's climate controlled, maybe inside of an RV, inside of a house, this will work perfectly. Excellent small size 100 amp hour mini battery. Definitely a good price. So hope this helps. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.